Ah, yes, welcome back, my lovelies. It is I, Sketchy, and this is my show, The Sketchy Show, where I bring you improv sketch comedy for your audio pleasure. And pleasure you today I will, for today brings with it some real zingy little zesty bits and bobs that I'm real proud of. Boy oh boy, I done gone all out on this one, haven't I? I'm feeling pretty chipper and bubbly, and maybe it's springtime, or maybe it's the oil change I just got, but man, when you're feeling it, know what I mean, buckaroos? Fuck yeah. Let's get right into it. Here's a sketch about an up-and-coming theme song artist.
Alright, hey guys, how's it going? How you doing?
I'm Flag. Hey, Aaron here. I'm so happy you could come in today.
Well, just in case anyone doesn't know, my name's Jeff. Jeff Yamaha.
Sorry, was that Yamaha or Yamaha?
Yamaha. It's a portmanteau.
Thanks. Sort of, sort of a stage name then?
Yes.
Okay.
You've probably heard of me.
Well, we heard of you through your sister, actually, Jessica Barnes.
Yes. Yeah. I've done her son's birthday party every year since he was born.
You mean your nephew's? Your nephew's party.
An audience is an audience.
Jessica works with us upstairs. She's great. We love Jessica. Don't we love Jessica? We love Jessica, don't we?
She's fantastic.
Gotta love Jessica.
Which one is she?
She's the tall one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's okay.
You came highly recommended to us, and I want to thank you so much. Would you say your name was Jeff Yamaha?
Yes, Jeff Yamaha.
Yamaha.
Emphasis on the ha-ha.
But we would make the check out to Jeff Barnes, right?
To Jeff Barnes, right?
Yes.
Legally. Thanks, okay.
Yes, Jeff Barnes. Okay.
Jeff, I want to thank you so much for coming in today. You know, you came highly recommended from your sister.
I'd like to thank you for the opportunity.
Absolutely.
You'd like to?
Let me just break it down real quick.
Thank you. Thank you so much for this opportunity.
You're welcome.
Thank you. I can check that off now. He thanked us.
Yeah, do you get
for
that?
For the opportunity. I got that.
Thanks, Mike. So, Jeff, I just want to lay it out real quick for you here. We have a lot to get through today, so we shouldn't waste any time. Our normal guy, James Buckworthy.
Yeah.
He's fantastic. He does all of the theme songs to all of our shows, all of our pilots. He was in a terrible accident. He's been in the hospital for weeks. We've been putting this off and off and off. Usually this guy gets through, you know, a dozen or two a day.
I'm so sorry to hear that.
Sorry, what was that?
I'm so sorry to hear that.
What was that noise?
I think he's trying to score the moment. Were you trying to score the moment, Jeff?
Is that what this is?
Yeah.
Okay, I love it.
Are you a moment scorer?
I do love it.
I love it. I'm glad you said you love it, because I was going to feel kind of strange saying I loved it without knowing if you loved it, and you said that. I love it. I love that you said that, but I'm also, I love it.
I love it, and I love that you love that I loved it. Flag, you know what I love the most?
What?
We're on the same page. Jeff, what do you think of that?
I think it's great. I don't think it's great of what happened to your normal guy, but I'm happy to be here.
Thank you so much.
What do you think of the synergy that we just had?
Oh, I thought that was a beautiful moment.
I thought it was just
one of those, like...
You know, just type of things.
I want you to take that feeling and I want you to run with it, because our first show is actually called Beautiful Moments. And it's a new show where... You remember America's Funniest Home Videos?
Yeah.
People would send funny videos. We find today that funny videos upset people. So this is a show where people send in videos of beautiful moments.
Okay.
Just beautiful moments. And so we do have, and this is the part that is going to maybe, I think... Going to be
a soundboard full of awes.
But we do have a hologram of Bob Saget that we're bringing in to be the host of Beautiful Moments.
Controversial.
Now, so the show is hopefully going to have an opening theme sung in the voice of Bob Saget. We have enough recordings of him to do a total deep fake. I mean, it's believable, frankly.
Yeah, it's incredible.
It's high tech.
Yeah.
And we think some people are going to love it. But some people are going to hate it.
Some people are going to love it.
So we want you to write a theme song for this one that captures all that. It's a half-hour show.
Personally, I hate it, but I'm not the one that decides.
Everyone hates it. I hate it.
Everyone hates it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Go. Okay. So theme song for Beautiful Moments.
Go.
The show.
We got to go now. Go.
All right. Hold on. Just want to make
from
sure.
From the point of view of Bob Saget.
Bob Saget, Beautiful Moments.
Beautiful moments, Talking about beautiful moments. Talking about beautiful moments with Bob Saget. That's it.
I'm crying. I'm actually crying. I didn't think I would be because I haven't felt anything in months. But I am crying right now.
I don't cry anymore. Wonderful. I'm all cried out. But I cried on the inside. And that's what counts.
You know what?
That means a lot.
Jeff, you know what?
I loved it. I'm so glad we were rolling on that because we got it.
Yeah, we got it. All right.
Moving on. Thank you. I'm checking it off the list. Checking it off the list, Aaron.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah.
All right. Next up, we have a new sitcom from America's favorite comedian, Louis C.K. So this is going to be a kind of a tough one to sell, we think, but it might play in middle America. The name of the sitcom is You Got Me. And it's him, you know, kind of owning up to everything and making right. It's him.
It's completely creepy. It's like the creepiest show.
It's super creepy because it's Louis. It's we got a beautiful actress playing his wife. We've got another beautiful couple actresses playing his daughters. And then on either side of him, both of his neighbors are both single women. And actually, across the street are more women. And all the women are comedians. It's like they live in like a gated community for comedians. And he's like the only man there. So he's like surrounded by women, and he's like tempted.
Okay.
Can't do anything about it. Can't do the stuff that he used to. And his catchphrase is "You got me." So let's hear that.
Okay. All right. And the title of the show is "You Got Me."
You got me.
Okay. Yeah. Some things I shouldn't have done. I did some things I wouldn't have won. I did some things I shouldn't have done. You got me. You got me. You got me. I got caught.
So we got that too, right? I mean, we've just been rolling this whole time. Okay, so we got that.
You got me. Yeah, and by you got me, I got it. We got it.
I'm crossing this off.
You got me.
All right, what do we got next, Flag?
All right, well, I got news for you. Everybody loves a reboot.
Yeah?
And that's the name of this show. Everybody loves a reboot.
Everybody loves a reboot.
Now, it may sound like I'm saying everybody loves a reboot, but it actually says everybody loves the reboot. And the reboot is going to be like this new character. It's going to be like, I mean, honestly, it's the next Jar Jar Binks.
Okay.
So
I love that guy.
It's a completely CGI character,
in,
right?
In the good way and the bad way. Both ways,
right.
There's a bad way?
So we got Ahmed Best.
Hold on. Are you joshing me? You got the Ahmed Best.
Ahmed Best is going to get a lot of work out of this because he's the grumpy landlord.
What a dream come true.
On Everybody Loves a Reboot. And he's always like hitting the floor or hitting his ceiling with his broom and saying up to the reboot who lives above him, "Keep it down up there, the reboot," you know. But anybody, everybody loves a reboot. It's all about how it's almost an ironic thing because if you watch the show, it doesn't seem like everybody loves him.
It seems like everyone hates him, yeah.
Okay. It gets pretty dark.
Everybody loves the reboot, lives upstairs. Let's see what we got. Jazzing up a little.
All right.
Everybody loves a reboot. Everybody loves a reboot. Everybody loves a reboot. Is he an alien? We don't know. How was that?
Will you do the voice of the reboot?
Yeah, I mean, if we pay you 2% more.
Will you do the voice?
That's a lot of money. Well, I thought Ahmed Best was being the reboot.
No, Ahmed Best is a landlord. No. That's like the manager.
Just a landlord.
Yeah.
What kind of voice do you want for the reboot?
Like a Ahmed Best kind of voice.
Yeah. don't ask me to try to imitate that.
Not like Ahmed Best, like just his regular speaking voice. I'm not talking about doing a Jar Jar voice. We'll table that idea.
We'll table it. I think we just got the theme. I'm writing a note right now. Jeff Yamahaha is the new the reboot. If it gets picked
up, we pass that over to me so I can check it off.
Yeah. Go ahead. Here.
Check it off. All right. I just checked it off.
Okay. Thanks.
Anything for you, buddy.
All right, Jeff. Our next show. It's a little dark. It's a little gritty. Kind of like CSI meets NYPD Blue meets Homicide: Life on the Street meets The Wire. Meets The Coroner, meets the gutter, you know, that kind of
meets
stuff.
The asphalt.
Okay.
It's the new show from David Simon. We're super excited about it. It's a dark, gritty take on police brutality, life as black men living in America. And it's called Sparks McKenzie Dog Cop.
Sparks McKenzie Dog Cop.
I think it's pretty self-explanatory.
All right. I'll do my best. I don't like that beat.
Chills.
Could you keep going up though for about 15 more minutes? Like each time going up a little higher?
Infinitely.
I would have, but I've reached the end of my keyboard.
Okay. Oh. Okay. Yeah. That's understandable. That's fine.
I'm gonna check off.
Check off finish keyboard and check off SparksMcKenzie.com.
SparksMcKenzie.com.
Thank you, Flake. Well, good job.
The next one is our last project that we hope to get before lunch. So I don't think I'm talking out of school when I say that this is probably the one that we're the most excited about.
Absolutely.
And so we're going to describe it to you in unison.
Yes, that's exactly how we do things with our other composer.
It's all about
the
pirate
president.
Movie. President. This is part of school. This is the part that's cool.
Yeah, it's super cool and unprecedented and unprecedented.
It's the first pirate movie to be so popular that it has a president. And so the presidential election for the pirate movie president,
it happens on,
tell him,
Mardi Gras.
Okay. And the title of the show?
We also need you to title this one.
Okay.
Yeah, it's untitled so far, so we want to see what you come up with. Really so, use those brain cells.
President of the Pirates. Okay. I'll do my best.
President of the Pirate Movie.
President of the Pirate Movie.
President of the Pirates Movie.
And
so Pirate
like,
President
also,
Movie.
And, oh, it's Mardi Gras. It's kind of like the backdrop.
Yeah. On Mardi Gras.
So it's Mardi Gras.
And okay, I would say Mardi Gras, wouldn't you say that like it's an ensemble piece, but Mardi Gras is the kind of like the fifth character.
Yeah,
you say?
Exactly. Yeah, you would definitely say Mardi Gras is the fifth character. Beads.
All right.
Bourbon Street.
Can you guys hear that all right?
Yeah, hearing it great. Good job, Jeff.
Okay. Let's do this. Nope. Need a different noise. Here we go.
I love watching the artist at work. Where? Who?
All right, just finding my place here.
Jeff, I get it. Yeah, this is fun. We should do this more often. We should do this every day.
He was alone, he was on top, he was alone, he was the cream of the crop, he was the president of pirates, he was the president of the pirates.
They will sue.
The movie.
Nice. You know, I like that.
That one was really soulful.
That one was good. Can you write down, he said presidents, he said pirates, he said movie. He didn't incorporate Mardi Gras, so I'm going to take a few points away.
This is not on here. I'll write that, but then you have to check it off.
We're doing a point system?
I've just decided we are. You know what?
Should I have another go at it?
Wait a minute. What? I just had a brainstorm here.
Yeah, go ahead. I love it. I want to hear it.
I mean, it's like an aneurysm. I might be dying.
It's a bad one, I can tell.
But what if, and maybe this will be my last thought, What if the main character's name is Mardi Gras? Is Mardi Gras.
I don't want to speak out of turn here, fellas, but I think that's a swell idea.
It's weird that it hasn't even been written yet, and we're scoring it and titling it and coming up with the characters' names. But I gotta say, I love it. I'm gonna tell Jessica about this right after lunch. Speaking of which, chicken tendies?
A song about chicken tendies? Okay.
No, lunch.
All Jeff, right, Jeff, song lunch. About chicken Jeff, tendies. No,
lunch. Jeff, lunch, chicken tendies.
All those songs are gonna be stuck in my head all day, but hey, I don't care. I love it. Everybody loves it. Everybody loves Zari Boot. Can't wait to watch that one. I hope it gets picked up for a full season. Hang on a second, do you smell that? Why, it's the unmistakable mush of old bourbon and a roaring fire, and probably some stuffed animals. It's been a while, so let's check in on two old drunk men by the fire.
Welcome to two old drunk men by the fire. One of your hosts is Nigel Starfleet.
And your other host is me, Alistair Post Thistle.
Yes, that's quite right.
As in, after the thistle.
You know what, Alistair? It's been 35 years plus 17. And that joke has never gotten less funny to me.
I enjoy it quite a bit. It took me a long time to perfect the timing of that joke.
You know, Alistair and I, Nigel, we are coming to you live from our newest quarters. We were kicked out of the hunting lodge because we were getting too old and too drunk.
We got yelled at for getting all of the hunting dogs drunk.
We hadn't been hunting in 25 years, and one of the old bucks, as you were, came in with 7 hares thrown over his shoulder, rabbits for some common folk. And he said, "What are these two old warts doing by my fire?"
And then they changed the bloody rules to where you actually have to hunt to hang out
at the
hunting lodge.
And I said, I have not been hunting since my first wife had my 5th child.
Nigh on 80 years
ago. It's been 500 years. And I don't look a day older.
720 years.
It's been so long that the last time I went hunting was with King Arthur. Jesus Christ, we're in a kennel.
Oh yeah, I remember Arthur, yeah. Really nice young lad. A terrible dancer.
Do you know what? I remember who was a good dancer.
Annie Oakley. Beautiful lady.
Quite. She really knew how to throw her ankles up.
And who was that chap that wore the cooking pot on his head?
Oh, yes. Pontius Pilate.
Yes, Pontius Pilate.
He would get so ripped.
I remember.
If we could convince him to do quite anything.
You know what always bothered me, Nigel?
What was that, Alistair?
Why is it all the old Romans in the films and the pictures speak with British accents?
Well, you know, it's because we were there and we told them how to speak.
Do you remember when we used to sound like Americans before they revolted, so we changed to this way of speaking to seem more high and mighty than them?
Yes, quite. Do you remember when we used to be Vikings?
Yes. And your beard could never quite grow in.
No, it was quite patchy. It was quite patchy, but I did find the time to braid it in between different bouts of mead.
Yes. And that one day you were bored and you were like, "Alistair, look what I did to the prow of this fine sailing vessel. I carved a dragon into it."
No, it's like, gigantic tits.
Oh, that's a great idea. Quite. We could scare all the little people
that we're pulling up on.
Also, why are Vikings always depicted with a British accent?
It was because we were there to teach them how to talk, I believe. Why do you think that they blamed all those horrible crimes on Jack the Ripper?
I never quite knew. I never really saw what the big deal was.
It was Henry that did it.
Yes, I know. He always had a thing for ladies
of
the night.
He had a thing for ladies of the night.
Name wasn't and then even they say, Jack.
His name is Jack the Ripper.
Yeah, Jack the Ripper.
It was more like Henry the alcoholic.
Yeah, more Henry the old alky on the ones and twos.
I dare say.
I dare you to say.
Still can't understand a fucking thing either of those two old bags have to say, but I like listening to them. It's like listening to old marbles slowly fall down a greasy pile of rocks. That makes sense, right? Hey, doesn't matter, cause it's time to pay the bills. This week's episode of The Sketchy Show is brought to you by Rocky Roadhouse.
Hey, you.
Yeah?
You look like a rough-kicking, hard-tooting kind of guy.
Goddamn right I am.
You know what you're missing, though?
What?
A fist full of ice cream.
Jesus fucking Christ, I fucking love ice cream.
Come on down to Rocky Roadhouse. It's the ice cream roadhouse down by the beach. The only ice cream roadhouse made for men and pure men. Are you tired of these pansy-ass ice cream flavors like vanilla and chocolate and mint? Ice cream, strawberry.
I don't know what sherbet means.
Yeah, sometimes you get this lemon mint sherbet bullshit, and you think to yourself, what am I, a woman child?
Or fucking 10?
You say 10 or tan?
10.
10. That's what I said, a woman child. It's the worst of both worlds. Well, down at the Rocky Roadhouse, we've got only the manliest ice cream flavors that you can experience, like mahogany.
Gravel?
Gravel? How about tar? Pure tar.
That isn't just gonna be a fancy name for black licorice, is it?
Fuck your black licorice. We hate the licorice taste. We only have the harshest, manliest, most devastating flavors you can imagine for ice cream.
Like slate?
Deckwood.
We've got all the manliest flavors. We've got...
ball sweat.
Yeah. We've got iron. We've got copper shavings. We've got, you know, when you're up on your roof and you slip... and you kind of fall across, what are those things called, the shingles? You fall on the shingles. Wait, and you're like...
You have shingle rash?
Yeah.
Shingle rash.
What about sawdust?
Sawdust.
Sawdust? We've got 8 different kinds of sawdust. We've got oak, we've got cedar, we've got pine, we've got plywood. We even have cherry, motherfucker. I'm not talking about cherry-flavored ice cream. I'm talking about the wood.
What about maple?
Maple.
What kind of car do you drive?
57 Chevy Bel Air.
Yeah? You got a Hemi in that Chevy?
Hemi.
I don't think they put Hemis in Bel Air.
We've got ice cream that tastes just like the Hemi, and you'll fucking thank God you got it because you've never tasted Hemi before. And when you taste Hemi, holy shit, you'll be running as fast as your fucking Chevy.
Do you have barbed wire flavor ice cream?
Barbed wire.
Barbed wire, motherfucker, we've got razor wire. Excuse me, sir. What kind of flavor are you getting tonight?
Do you have a flavor that tastes like the dry inside of my own mouth?
I believe you're talking about hate. Yeah, we've got hate. We've got all of the emotions that men feel. Hate, anger, lust, and the satisfaction of finishing a garage bill.
Give me a hate sundae. Make it so dry.
Do you have flavored ice cream?
Hell yeah, we've got... flavored ice cream. We've got.
Not under my roof.
Have you ever wondered what it tastes like to tell kids to get off your lawn?
All the damn time.
Well, we've got that goddamn flavor, and you're gonna fucking love it.
Love it.
Do you have the flavor of never telling your son you love them?
Really sad.
Do you mean Bobby?
Bobby.
Bobby. Bobby. Bobby, do you want to eat some ice cream with your daddy?
Please, just some mint chocolate chip, daddy.
Mint chocolate chip? God damn it. What have I been saying this whole fucking time? We don't have mint chocolate
chip. Okay, daddy. Okay, daddy. How about just the flavor of a long-awaited reconciliation?
You know, I could go in the back and I could see if we have that one. We've got all those flavors and more down at the Rocky Roadhouse Ice Cream for Men. So what are you waiting for? Get in your Chevy. Come on down. We're on the coastal highway. You can't miss us.
I'd love to go check out that ice cream shop, but I'm not a manly dude. Maybe I can dress up like one. Put on a cowboy hat, wear some plaid and denim, roll around in the dirt and stuff. They'll let me right in. Wow, we've almost made it to the end of the show and I can't believe it because I've had such a good time tickling you behind your hearing bits, but all good things must come to an end, right? So let's go out on a really high note. It's time once again for Basil Gin, Super Spy. Yes, 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 yes.
All right, boys and girls, it's time to pull out your child-sized tumblers and your child-sized flasks, for it is time for Basil Gin, Super Spy.
My name is Basil Gin, Super Spy. I am the world's most greatest spy, but I hail from England.
Once again, he is here to save us all from the troubles of communism.
I hate it when people commune to do crimes.
This week on Basil Gin Super Spy, he faces his greatest threat yet. Will he escape? Will he die? Find out on this week's episode of Basil Gin Super Spy, Basil versus the Volcano.
Basil?
Doody dum 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 dum, diddly dum dum dum. Oh, Basil, you've done it again. I've just come back from a successful mission in which I liberated the peoples of Tanzania. And
Basil?
Boy, did I liberate some of them, the women. I liberated them from their clothes. I wish I could tell someone about it.
Basil.
Oh, my Christ communicate here. Yes, hello. This is Basil Gin, Super Spy, speaking.
Hello, Basil. This is the Chief.
Ah, Chief. Yes, what? Hello, good aftermorn to you.
Good aftermorn to you, Basil. Thank you for keeping proper decorum.
Are you drinking as much as I am currently?
Of course I am. I'm actually drinking too. Here, I'll ching them together.
Let's ching. That's not racist.
I already did it, Basil. You're too late.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm drinking from my decanter of whiskey.
How did the mission go?
What?
How did the mission go?
Which mission? Oh, the Tanzania Liberation!
Yes, did you get the Prime Minister of Tanzania out of Tanzania?
Was that what I was supposed to be doing? The Prime Minister? I went to Tanzania, and I met the most beautiful woman. Her name was Hillary Shedd. I couldn't figure out what that meant, but I figured it was a local colloquialism. Anyway, I helped her and her tribe. Is that what they're called there, tribes?
I imagine so, Basil.
Well, I fought some people and killed them, so I came back.
So, you have no details to give me on the whereabouts of the Tanzania Prime Minister?
No. But, you know, I'm sure he's fine. I found a lot of people, they had crates of weapons. I dashed them. Thusly, I can't imagine any bad people are left in the country, and, well, you know how these things go, Chief. They'll be good.
Yes, I do know how these things go, but at the same time, though, it just seems like you do not remember why you were even there to begin with. Do you think I talk to other people through their watches?
Yes. Yes? Am I the only one?
We have 70 other agents, but you are the only one I keep an eye on.
Oh, so I'm special.
You're my best man, Basil.
Thank you, Chief. You're my best man. At the wedding that I'll have one day. Wink, wink.
Well, I was your best man to your wedding to Rosemary.
Shit, I forgot I was married.
And that didn't work out.
Yes, it's a shame about Rosemary, Gin. She and I had to split up after that kerfuffle. in Sweden.
That kerfuffle, that is a complicated word, Basil.
It was a complicated situation, Chief. You know Rosemary. Swinging a lot of boots, she was. Anyway, that's the past, and tomorrow's the future. But today is the present.
Basil, do shut up.
Shutting up, Chief.
Do you mind telling me what the next part of your mission is?
The next part of my mission? Hang on. I have it here. One second. Let me look in my ledger.
I do hope you didn't write it down, Basil.
I didn't write it down.
Classic spy class says you should memorize things.
Mistake number one. First day on the job, Chief. what? That would be so silly. No. The next part of my mission... Well, let's see. I've just gotten back to my flat. I'm on my sixth decanter of whiskey.
Wait. You're already back in England.
Yes. Chief, what is the next part of my mission?
Well, I was hoping you would tell me. Because it was a test, Basil.
Shit!
The next part of your mission, which a large part of it was you coming back to England from that kerfuffle that you were in.
Ha! Nailed it!
Do take another sip, and let me finish. Basil, we have received a message from Baron Draconius Volcano.
Who?
Your nemesis.
This certainly is news to me, Chief. I've never heard of the chap. Sounds like small fish to me.
It seems as though every case you've been on up until this point, even though seemingly unrelated, has been connected to this character.
Even the time the souvlaki place got my order wrong?
I'm afraid so, Basil.
That dastardly bastard! I love my souvlaki.
I wish to play for you this message from Baron Draconius Volcano. It seems as if he is baiting you.
Well, I dare say, Chief, I am quite keen to hear it. Let's listen to what this Baron Volcano... Baron Draconius... Volcano. Was that his name?
Chief, I've got some dreadful news.
Who?
Yes, what Chief. Is it, R? Chief.
Who is that?
Hello, Basil. It's me. It's me, R.
What's going... Who?
It's R.
Just me, R, back at home. Back at the home office, you know.
Who?
Anyway, Chief. The tape deck that we were using to...
Speak up!
To play the message from Baron Draconius Volcano. Well, it's eating the tape, sir.
Ah! Dashed again, I see.
Basil wasn't supposed to hear that. Basil, I'm terribly sorry. You weren't supposed to
I'm
hear that.
I'm on the news, wrist Dad. Radio.
Basil, shut it.
Okay. That's fine.
He had a long message for us all in which he laid out his plan, and he gave us all clues as to how to stop him. You know how he likes to play it.
So ate the tape.
I am afraid to say the tape was entirely eaten. When we pulled it out, it was all stretched and wrinkled. We tried to play it. And I have to say, that was a comedy of errors. Our fingers tangled up in the tape. Tape cracking this way, that.
So
the message has been destroyed.
What in the blazes are we supposed to do now?
Well, we were able to hear the first portion of the tape before it was eaten by the deck.
And is it Draconius himself?
It is. It appears to be him, sir. It matches the voice imprint that we have from the previous messages that do seem to be connected to verified volcano, attacks.
Right. Well, let's play it for Basil before he gets distracted.
I can only repeat the words as transcripted. We cannot play the message. We no longer have the recording.
All right.
But would you like me to do a voice?
It would be better for him if you pretended that this was a recording.
Okay.
So just do your best impression.
Okay,
he won't know the difference.
So, Chief, here's what I suggest. I want you to hold up this tape player, right?
Yes.
And I will hide behind you and do the sounds coming from the tape player.
Well, it's all audio. It's going through his watch. We don't have to worry about
visuals. He doesn't even have a video watch? What's he doing out there with the last year's technology?
Why would I spend our budget on video watches when...
Everyone else has one, sir. I'm actually watching you on my watch.
Well, that seems redundant.
I'm able to get the angle I like, sir.
Well,
yeah, look,
I
see?
Am quite dashing.
But look this, I think I found your best.
Oh my damn, that looks quite well.
I'll tell you what, I'll send you that. You can use it as a profile pic or something. There you go.
All right, so we're going to give the
yes, I'll
the
pretend
information.
To be the tape. I'll pretend to be in the tape, that's correct. That's a good idea.
Gin.
Good idea. Great idea, capital idea, sir.
All right, so
Basil? Basil!
Oh, yes, Chief, yes, quite. I was just humming to myself for quite a long time.
I had to say your name twice, Basil.
I'm sorry. I was singing the Rolling Stones.
What are you supposed to do when I have to say your name twice?
Drink twice. Once. Twice. Three times, Basil.
All right, Basil. Do listen up. We have a lot of intel on what you're about to do.
Yes, go ahead, Chief. I'm all ears. Chief, I said I'm all ears, but I can't hear you.
It appears that we have a recording of Baron Draconius Volcano himself.
The fiend!
Plotting against you.
What did I do to him?
Quite a lot. You've killed 7 of his daughters.
Oh, my God.
And, of course, they all tried to seduce you to further his own ends.
Okay. So you're telling me that 7 of the women I've killed, in understandable self-defense, after... Here's the thing. I typically seduce women on a day-to-day basis. Some of them are what you would call... girl next door types. You know, your Mary Sue's, your Lindsay Buckingham's, those types. And some of them... and some...
That's such a dumb joke.
And some of them...
Yes.
And the other one...
7
wait, I wasn't finished. I wasn't finished with my joke. Some of them, though, are more fatal. And you might call them... fatales, preceded by the word femme. And those ones, after I seduce them, they try to kill me. And because I'm so trained in self-defense and murder, I just end up killing them. Or, you know, sometimes someone else tries to shoot me or throw a throwing knife and I'll grab the woman who's turned out to be quite a bitch and I'll turn her. And the knife will go right into her back and she'll die. And a lot of people have given me some shit about this over the years. But, you know, it's just self-defense. What am I to do if someone wants to cover me in molasses, but I'm not around, and they find her lying there, so they cover her in molasses, and then the field agents tell me, oh, Basil, do you know how this one died? She's got a lung full of molasses. What am I to do about that? I wasn't there. I didn't kill her. I'm not responsible just because I let my penis do the talking for the 10,000th time. Chief, I fear I've gone off on a tangent. You better just play that tape.
All right, Basil. This is an actual tape of...
Yes, why wouldn't it
Baron
be?
Baron Draconius Volcano talking about you.
Excellent. Can't wait to hear him.
That is the noise that the tape recorder... makes
clearly
when I hit the button.
Yes.
Oh, and it is playing now.
Yes. It is me. You know me. You've heard me before. So, no bother. Don't bother trying to remember me. Just hear me now.
Okay.
And think about the future that I bring to you. I bring to you on a silver platter.
Ooh,
Basil.
That sounds nice.
I bring to you death and torment.
Ooh, less nice.
And it is all, it is a payback, a vicious payback. Chief, what is he paying you back for?
This sounds very unrehearsed.
Basil killed a lot of his daughters.
What's the payback for?
A lot of whispering going on in this recording.
The daughters, one wound shall I inflict upon thee for every daughter, all
Seven.
All 7 daughters of mine that I have lost to you.
Ooh.
You will feel a wound of pain and torment
inflicted
upon
thee.
I'm not very good at this.
It's biblical.
As so it shall be written, so it shall be done.
Positively.
Upon thee, I leave thine these 3 clues as to my true location.
Ooh, I'm picking up my ledger, and I'm going to write down the clues. Yes, go ahead, right. Mr. Volcano.
As you should, Basil.
Where would you like for him?
I'm listening.
I was thinking...
I said I was
Cairo.
All ears. Cairo. C-A-I-R-O.
Is there a place I could go where it would cost like the least?
Cairo, I haven't been there in like 2 decades.
Where he won't cause trouble.
Kuala Lumpur.
Kuala Lumpur. I don't know how to spell that, so I'm just going to write down Kuala Lamprey. I'll figure it out. I'll know what I meant later.
Phoenix, Arizona.
Ah, Phoenix, Arizona.
This recording had pauses built into it so that you could write those things down, but no more pauses, no more chances, no more instructions, no more clues. Dear. You, Basil Gin, must defeat me on your own merits and with your own wits, or it's off with your head and off with your hands and every last bit of you off with it and fed to the dogs.
I hope he's not talking about my legendary penis.
We will leave that intact.
Is he responding to me on this recording?
Shit. Chief. Cantaloupe.
Beep, click,
click. Oh, the tape. That's the end of the tape, Basil.
The tape just ended.
That's fine, Chief. I have enough information to go off of for my next mission, where I track down my nemesis, Baron Draconius Volcano.
Yes, and please, do keep casualties, innocent casualties, to a minimum.
I'll do my best, Chief, but you know, I am not to be held responsible for my actions. That has never been the case. It's one of the reasons why I love this job. No responsibility whatsoever.
Well, it's a part of your license to thrill.
And thrill I do, Chief. I'm looking at my ledger. It looks like the first place I'm off to will be Cairo, in the land of Egypt. The next place, I wrote down Kuala Lumpur. I don't know what that means at all.
Kuala Lumpur.
That sounds similar. The third place, Phoenix, Arizona.
It is a dangerous place, Basil.
It is a wretched hive of scum and villainy. Here's the thing, Chief. I can't get over the second thing I wrote down. I wrote down Kuala Lamprey. Those are two different animals.
Basil?
I'm off to go track down my nemesis, the hideous Baron Draconius Volcano.
Yes, he is historically ugly.
Is he? I literally have never heard of him before today.
Which is insane, because he is obsessed with you.
And honestly, I don't remember his daughters. The seven of them, they could have been any of the women I've killed. It's been dozens.
I almost feel like everything he's done has been according to plan, but everything you've done has been completely by accident.
Yes, as the Americans say, that is the way I roll. And on that note, I'm going to roll like a stone. I was singing them to myself earlier. I do like that Mick Jagger. Do you know that song where he's like, pretty, 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 pretty girl? I like that song. It's a bit repetitive. Oops, Alexa, shut up. I don't know why that happened.
I swear, with my agents, I can't get no satisfaction.
That concludes this week's episode of Basil Gin Super Spy.
I bet we're building to an epic showdown between Basil and the Baron, and tea's gonna be super sweet. Or, it could be like a big turd of a letdown. But that's the risk you take, isn't it? You can't fly that close to the sun without risking exploding into a fiery ball of awesomeness. Fly high, my pretties, go into the sun and ascend to greatness. And never forget, I love you.
The Sketchy Show is a Cactus Radio production. You can contact us at podcast@cactusrodeo.com. Subscribe and follow on iTunes, Stitcher, and Spotify, and follow Cactus Rodeo on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter for more entertainment and updates.